I'm pretty, you know, as Americanized as you can get. At the same time, I mean, growing up, there are times where people would make presumptions about me or make fun of me or insult me because of my ethnicity. I remember when I was a kid, every time we put up Christmas lights, you know, kids would come by and smash their Christmas lights. Probably is an interesting guy. I mean, when I first met him, I just thought, kind of wrote him off as a crazy kook. But in between the random kind of innate nonsense, there's actually like gems and nuggets of information that are actually useful.
All of you look Chinese to me. They don't like that. They do.
A lot of people can't differentiate among Asian Americans. I mean, Asian American is a very broad term that encompasses a broad range of communities, and we're not all alike.
Just straight out, like, I trust you.
No, yeah, I feel that's like... You're from the very beginning, yeah.
Becky, she's a lawyer, but she does a lot of nonprofit work. I respect that, and I don't think someone like that is likely to be in this game just to make a lot of money. So I trust her. Going to Exile Island really sucked. There's pretty much nothing on it.
I feel like I have a pretty strong connection with members of my tribe. I miss them, hopefully they miss me, and it'll be an opportunity just to uncover the immunity idol.
The last time you can use any hidden immunity idol is when there are 4 survivors remaining in the game.
I found the immunity idol, which is probably the single biggest stroke of luck I could have had. If there's a clear opportunity where it can change the game, I'd use it.
You know, you're in a situation where I could save your butt. I mean, I'll do it.
Oh, I appreciate that. No, I trust you. You know that I trust you.
Yeah. Becky and I have, I think, a tight bond and strong alliance coming out of our Puka tribe. You know, I think it's a huge advantage in this game to have someone that you can absolutely trust. And I think given our backgrounds and our common interests, so I felt comfortable disclosing the information to her. Right now, we have our solid 4 alliance. Myself, Jonathan, Becky, and Candace. Cowboy and Flecka voted with us last tribal council, but it's just hard to be in any kind of strategic alliance with him because you have no idea what's going to happen on a day-to-day basis. We need a 5th in order to have the numbers. Sandra, I think, is someone that everyone is kind of leaning towards because she seems not to be a manipulative person. She seems that if she were to commit, that she would be very dependable. And, you know, she's kind of out here by herself, and I think she's looking for a home.
I realized we got 6 votes, and what if we have the item? We put 3 votes on each of them.
Cowboy believes that Jonathan has a hidden immunity idol. So Plan Voodoo would split our votes between Jonathan and Candace, forcing a 3-3 tied, and if Jonathan has the hidden immunity idol, it'd force it to be played. And so that way you accomplish 2 goals. 1, you get the hidden immunity idol out of Jonathan's hands, and 2, you get one of those 2 people to go home.
That's very interesting.
At least we weaken a number, one way or another. Think about it. It's the only strategy I could think of to work.
That's a very interesting idea. I think the plan is ingenious. I know that neither Jonathan or Candace have the hidden immunity idol, because I have it. But it's a great plan to break down Jonathan's alliance with the members of the original white tribe. I do feel bad that people have to go. I'd like to try to play the game with as much integrity and honesty as I can. I'm finding it to be very, very complicated because I feel like people do trust me, but as a result of that, they think I'm in a number of separate alliances with them, and obviously I can't be in alliance with everyone. So for me, it's a question of how far can you get in this game, and who do I trust? I know that Jonathan, for some reason, seems to inspire some level of mistrust among pretty much everybody. If you talk to anybody, including other people in our alliance, they feel like he's a gamer. He's here to play hard, and people don't fully trust him. And for me, I haven't seen it, but because everyone else is suspicious of him, I mean, it can't help but rub off on me a little bit.
I'm offering each of you the opportunity to mutiny and join the other tribe. Candace is mutinying. 1. Jonathan mutinies at the last second. That is it.
For us, we don't really have any strategic options other than to win.
We are the underdogs. All we have to do is our best.
We have to work together. We have to be a team. If we've been having challenge after challenge after challenge, not getting a whole lot of downtime to recover. And yesterday and today, I just feel really crappy. I'm getting a little bit worried, especially going forward, that it's going to be a problem.
I'm really looking forward to getting to know the people on the other side I've never got a chance to interact with.
I've always, hey, man, you know, I like you. You got class.
Yeah, you do.
He does. We have a new identity now. We've merged into one tribe, but the fact of the matter remains that we're still divided into 2 tribes, and as Aitutaki came in with fewer numbers, things look pretty bleak.
We seriously thought it was going to be over for us, and the fact that we're still here, it's good.
We're trying to figure out if there's any chink in the armor in Rarotonga. We desperately need to convince someone to come over to our side.
I'm trying to think, what's the danger of them knowing that I have the island? I'm not sure there's a whole lot of danger, to be honest. They don't have numbers to arrange a split vote.
Our backs are against the wall. We need someone to flip. We've kind of come up with a desperate plan. based on the fact that I had the hidden immunity idol, and it could change, hopefully, the whole flow of the game.
I do not believe that Ozzy would trust me. I'm not sure why you would trust me.
Jonathan deserted us.
We had an alliance going, and he turned his back on the alliance and, you know, basically left us for dead.
But at the same time, like, you know, I don't really have an option here. I gotta figure out something that's gonna work, and this might work.
No, Jonathan's not playing us. There's always a possibility he's doing this just to throw his name off our target.
It's entirely possible that Jonathan's pretending to go along with the plan in order to direct the vote away from him onto Nate. And if he doesn't vote with us tonight, I'm gonna play the idol, and once it's played, then I'm vulnerable. I don't want to do that. So, I don't know. I'm hoping somehow all this clicks together. So at Tribal Council, I think everyone was holding their breath. I believe Jonathan, and I believed he was sincere in switching over, but I wasn't sure. It was a huge risk that we took, but this is how I wanted to play the idol. I wanted to play it at a point in time where it, you know, resets the entire game in your favor. And it worked. Adam, Parvi, and Candace approached me today. They really want Jonathan out of the game. So they asked me, kind of appealing to my sense of, you know, justice and integrity, to please vote him off first. Yeah, maybe we should just hide the food for a couple of days. Ozzy catches pretty much most of our food, and Adam and Parvati keep on winning these challenges. So I think at this point we've tentatively decided to keep on catching food, but maybe hide some of it from Adam and Parvati.
Never had a massage?
No.
Kidding me. Oh, you're in for a treat.
We got a massage after that, which was awesome. It's a nice reminder of life outside of this game.
I just peed in my pants, and I wasn't even wearing any.
I don't know if Parvati is flirting with Ozzy only because she's hoping that there might be some strategic option there. Ozzy, to some extent, might be reciprocating. I mean, if Ozzy responds in some way, maybe somewhere down the line, something might come up. I would not be happy going to the final two with Ozzy. Any one of us going against Ozzy would be likely to lose on the jury. Ozzy has been getting a lot of favor with members of the old Railroad tribe because they perceive him as being, you know, kind of a pure player. He's doing his own thing. He's not strategizing. He's not building coalitions. He's playing a straight-up game and doing a hell of a job of it. Today, Ozzy won immunity, as usual. I mean, he's just becoming bigger and bigger threat. So we're all pretty aligned on voting out one of the Railroad folks, either Adam or Parvati. It's just a question of who to vote out first. The Aititaki 4 has made it to the final four. Also, I still have the hidden immunity idol, which I can still play in the final four. So I've maneuvered myself into a very good position. But now it's a different ball game. I'm hoping it'll be relatively clean, but you know, if it just gets ugly, then we'll see what happens. I am so glad that the winner of Survivor is going to be from a minority community. I think it speaks volumes that oftentimes the strongest teams are the ones that have a diversity of perspectives and backgrounds. And the fact that we were able to bond so tightly together and really kind of succeed under very long odds, I think is a great morality tale.
It's like a cooked beef!
The fact that I was able to start this whole adventure with Becky on day one, the fact that I'm able to finish it with her, you know, it's gotta be a dream, right?
Oh, congratulations, guys!
Finding a really good friend is worth more than $1 million. I mean, friendships like the one that I have with Becky, I think, are that rare. I tried to play the game with as much integrity as I could. I know that I failed in a lot of respects, but, you know, hopefully people won't hold it against me that I beat them.
The winner of Survivor Cook Islands.